Hi, and welcome back to our Open Stop Motion film project. I'm sorry I'm late, because the kids' workshop went on a little longer, and I have been ill all weekend, so I haven't got preparation like I should have, and so on. A lot of problems and that kind, but now we are on, and I need, before we start, the printer is just gotten finished with a couple of trees, and now I want to put another on, but I have to start the camera over there, so just a minute. And then we'll see. I have to close that one. And I will get that to fit better. That looks all right. So I will start it up. What? I need my pincher. So I got it to work this weekend. I got it to work again, but it's still very messy, but that's not more than we can pics afterwards. And I think I know what the problem is with that. And the problem is that when I cleaned the extruder, because it was kind of not cluttered, but it's not just plastic cluttering in it, but kind of burnt stuff on the inside of the tube, so I had to remove that. And you know, when the extruder moves from one place to another, it kind of retracts the plastic, it extrudes. So, but when they are coming false air inside it, when it extracted, then you have these thread. So, and I can see it on the side here too, the way it kind of do some stuff here. It's you know, it's something I can see. But I have to take it apart, and then I have to try to clean it in another way. I'm not sure how and with what, but I will figure something out. But it do print, but there's all this hairy stuff on it, but it's quick to sand off, but I want it to print perfect. But that will not be today, because what I need now is to finish the one I have on here. So I can, and the two I have standing there, because I need some new trees to print and not the same over and over again. So we need to get a little more diversity in the forest. So so I have to see if I can get time to scan some in tomorrow and start to print some new ones tomorrow. And the ones, those two behind there, I can print shall we say, 20, 30 of each. But when we come to these little more different, then we will only make a few of each. So we are starting to come to that part where we need to make some more diverse stuff. I need a paper towel. But I had promised on the kids today in the kids workshop that I will finish the catapult, so I had to do that. I guess they will not wait another week for that to finish. So, and now I will clean the glasses so I can see where I am and what I'm doing. But I had a really bad weekend, so, and I'm not that fit for fight today either, but that's how it is. And we haven't time for that nonsense. And I don't know if TD Games are looking now, but I have answered. He asked how long it would take with this, and I guess some other people like to know how long it will take before we actually end up having a movie, but that is very hard to say. And as I said to him that next year this time I maybe have a better idea, because this is 80 minutes of stop motion. It's a very, very big process. So, and it of course all depends on how much help I can get, and but the way I have started this is to get other people to help. You need to show that you can keep your end of the game, and so I just built the studio and I bought a lot of stuff and started on it, and then I guess the interest comes when I get further on in the process. But and a lot of the physical things I'm making, nobody can help with that, because we cannot send those kind of things around the world, but we can digital stuff, bits we can send around. So that's more that kind of stuff I wanted help with, like sound files and music, and I know some people who are good at music stuff, but I don't know if they want to help me, because this is free stuff, and I do this for free, and everyone else has to do their bits for free too. So we'll see how that goes, and I don't know how many will help me and if any at all will help me. So if I'm going to do it the whole caboodle myself, then it would take a lot of time, and it's very hard to see how much and how little time it will take. So it's just get on with it and make as much as possible in as short time as possible. That's the only thing I can do, and then I'll see. But enough of that talk. I started on this one last time, and I should straighten it up a little. And you can see that's a little tilted and so on, and that's on purpose, because not every tree in the woods are straight up, and this not. We need to find my tools again. Me, this is also all this live streaming is, of course, there is also a big learning process in that. As one of the guys, tech guys, I really follow and love Leo Laporte. As he says, he was not very good his first 10 years, so maybe I don't have 10 years to learn it, but and he's a talk show host, and that's a whole other kettle of fish. I'm making stuff, that's something else, so I hope. I hope I'm better at that than that I am at the talk show host abilities or whatnot. Plus that you guarantee can hear that English is not my native tongue, so that's kind of a little difficult too sometimes. Sometimes I ran out of words and so on. But I hope that over time I will get better. Thing I can do. And then I'm the worst person in the world to multitask. I forget to record and forget a lot of stuff. So, because my head is filled up with this instead. Try my best to do it as good as possible. I could of course sit here and make it on my own without the cameras on, but then no one would knew that I would know that I did this, and then I will never be able to get any help. That's the advantage of the net and the social network. I have a lot of good friends on Google Plus, and I have a lot of followers on Facebook and so on. I have been on here for years, not making this or streaming stuff, but like everyone else, and made a lot of friends. Met a lot of really nice people. Now it starts to rain. And we are on the top floor, so the roof is right over our head, and it can be a little bit noisy when it starts raining. I think it needs a little oil. the other trees were more kind of fill trees, but now we have to make some more interesting ones too. And these trees are, of course, not a particularly kind of trees. They are just my imagination trees. And I don't even know now how this is gonna look. But you have some ideas in your head. And that's just what I follow. And sometimes it works, and sometimes it don't. And then we can cross it all together. That lay together and start over, or keep on putting on and taking off until it looks like. That's the beauty of this material. You are not locked in. Time nor form. So that's a good thing. be the worst tree like this in the Stone Age. They are just extinct. I know. Maybe. Never know. Maybe someone do, but I don't. Fiction is fiction. Some freedom then. You wouldn't have otherwise. London. I'll change this coffee with some hot. Stop instead. Oops. Once upon a time, there was a peak ranch here and now it's gone. Must have been a storm or something. This way. I have to look. I think racing. just sounded a little violent, but it isn't that much. cramp in my fingers. Thank you. Fun how it sticks to copper but it don't to the other metal I use. That's a little funny. Don't stick to these, but I stick to this. So I need to find something else. Cover.
I
It's kind of fun that something goes and something don't. Even when it's kind of homemade like this is. Nature has its own ways. It's in here somewhere. It's just a question of getting it out. That was more what I was after. A little drama. But I need a short visit to the bathroom. You can keep an eye on this one. It's kind of gotten a little soft in the middle because I have fumbled around with it a lot. Thank you. But a lot of trees we can own, we can first make when we start to build a landscape, because some of them have to stand on uneven terrain, and then we have to be able to form the root after the terrain they are standing on. So so we kind of make some of the things we need while we are building the landscape. To move the printer and the big tree, but so we can only make these a certain amount of these trees. Where we want what, or what we want where, or whatever you would say it. This would be a typical tree standing on the brink by the sea. With this kind of roots. and I have the material to get the big one finished. It is so tall that I have problems putting cameras on it while I'm doing it. So because of the studio is too small. But I always complain about that. But that is a fact. Hard to get the distance I need to make some shots while I'm working. To find a solution on that, because it's so tall. To finish the top, I have to stand on the table. Or something else, but we will figure out something. That is too little, isn't it? Yes. Thank you. Oops. Always do that. Put my nails in it. Stop it. It's a little too soft now. So we're gone. When I work on this, I should have an AC in here so I could set the temperature just right. But I guess that's a little problematic with the light and all. Right now it's like chewing gum. What can we use? This one's this. To get a little more stiff. What can we do? I saw it this weekend where I was feeling ill and sitting, feeling sorry for myself. I was looking on the net and then I saw the stop motion paranormal. They have cataloged 30,000 different faces, impressions. So you can see that's a lot. They had a whole library. Face expressions. Kind of phonetic and what they were expressing. If you don't have seen that film yet, then you should do that because that's really good. Very well made and some really clever people who made that. And a porn film. Anyway, I liked it a lot. great inspiration. But that's not the way I'm gonna do this. I will try to do this. Without any computer stuff. Maybe that's naive, but we will see. But at least that's the goal right now. Get on better thoughts along the way. And it's not because it will get easier with computer generated CGI stuff. It will, but we'll see when we get that far. If it's possible in my way, it is. A lot of other people have made it that way. Where you are animating the figures along the way, even with the mouth and eye movement. Without changing faces. When we come to that, we will make some experiments and then see what solution we will, which road we will take. One never knew. what I have said along the way that there will be a lot of learning and a lot of mistakes and so on. So there's no easy route to this. But we will lift one little stone at a time, and sooner or later we will be able to lift the big ones too. But once again, we have reached midnight, and we will go on to replay, and then I will load this episode up. Very soon we have, made 100 episodes of this. Some of them are too long to upload. They are over 6 hours. So but now they are 4 hours and we are uploading them. I will stop and try to get some rest and see if I can get super duper to tomorrow so I can be well again. And I'll thank you for watching, and we will go on to replay, and see you again tomorrow. Thank you and good night from Denmark.